Hello friends, today we will discuss about the magnetism and magnetic materials. So first of all we see about the atomic magnetic dipole. What is the meaning of atomic magnetic dipole? We well know about the structure of atoms, that is atom consists of a central core, that is nucleus, and electrons revolving around the nucleus in a stable circular orbit. Electron possesses two types of motion, that is orbital motion and spin motion of electron. This is about the structure of atom. Here we know that electron revolving around the nucleus in a stable circular orbit, this is known as orbital motion of electron. Motion of electron is a uniform circular motion. So electron revolving around the nucleus in an UCM, this motion consider as a current loop. That is, motion of electron consider as a current loop. We know that flow of electron is nothing but it is flow of current. So motion of electron can be considered as a current loop, and due to this current loop, electron possesses some magnetic dipole moment, or electron possesses some magnetic moment, and this magnetic moment, or due to this magnetic moment, we consider atomic dipole or atomic dipole moment. So electron revolving around the nucleus in a stable circular orbit, so motion of electron can be considered as a current loop, and due to this, current flowing through the loop is nothing but I is equals to charge upon time. We know that current is equals to charge upon time, so I is equals to minus E upon capital T. Minus E be the charge on electron and capital T be the time period of revolution of electron, and we know that capital T is equals to 2 pi r by V, where 2 pi r is the circumference, that is the distance covered by the electron in a one revolution, and capital T is the time period. So time period is equals to T is equals to 2 pi r by V. V is nothing but it is a velocity of electron, or we can say it's a speed of electron, because electron performing UCM. So current I is equals to minus E V upon 2 pi r. Therefore magnetic moment, here magnetic moment is denoted by mu. Mu is the symbol used for the magnetic moment. Sometimes we use a capital M also. So mu is equals to I into A. I be the current flowing through the due to the electron, and A is the area of the circular loop, and that is a pi r square. So I is equals to minus EV divided by 2 pi r, and A is equals to pi r square. So cancelling the pi and r, we get magnetic moment, that is atomic magnetic moment, mu is equals to minus EV r by 2. That is a magnetic dipole moment of an atom, of a single electron. Here we know that consider m is the mass of electron, and by multiplying and dividing by m, we get again mu is equals to E divided by twice m into mvr. Mvr is nothing but it is a angular momentum, that is L. So mu is equals to minus E divided by twice m into capital L. Mu is a magnetic moment, which is vector quantity. L is also vector quantity. Here negative sign indicate that the direction of magnetic moment is exactly opposite to the direction of angular momentum. Angular momentum is an axial vector. It is along the axis of rotation. So mu arrow is exactly opposite to the L arrow. That is, the direction of magnetic moment is exactly opposite to the direction of angular momentum. That is a magnetic moment of an atom of single electron. Here experimentally it is found that electron revolving around the nucleus, that is the orbital motion of electron, and this magnetic moment is nothing but it is orbital magnetic moment, because it is due to the orbital motion of the electron. Again there is a one spin motion of electron revolving or rotating about its own axis also. So due to this, electron possesses the spin motion, and due to spin motion of electron having the spin magnetic moment also. That is, we consider mu L is the orbital magnetic moment and mu S is the spin magnetic moment. Both are vector quantities. So total magnetic moment of atom, that is a total magnetic moment of electron, is nothing but it is vector sum of spin magnetic moment and orbital magnetic moment. That is mu is equals to mu L arrow plus mu S arrow. And due to this, electron has some magnetic moment, and due to that, atom has also some magnetic moment. That is the magnetic moment of atom. Magnetic moment is denoted by mu, and its SI unit is ampere meter square. As we know, mu arrow is equals to mu L arrow plus mu S arrow, means a vector sum of orbital magnetic moment and spin magnetic moment of an atom is equals to total magnetic moment. If this total magnetic moment mu arrow is equals to zero, then this substance is known as diamagnetic substance. If this vector sum, that is mu L arrow plus mu S arrow is equals to mu arrow, this mu arrow is non-zero but small, then it is known as a paramagnetic substances. In some atoms, it is found that mu arrow, that is the total magnetic moment, mu arrow is non-zero but large, then the material is known as a ferromagnetic material. What is diamagnetic material, what is paramagnetic material, and what is ferromagnetic material, we see later. First of all, we see some about some definitions. First definition is, what is a magnetization vector? Or we can say it's an intensity of magnetization. It is also known as magnetization. What is about the magnetization? Magnetization is denoted by capital M. So magnetization is defined as, it is the ratio of magnetic dipole moment per unit volume. Or magnetization is defined as magnetic dipole moment per unit volume. Means M arrow is equals to magnetic dipole moment, that is mu, upon volume, that is V. Means mu by V is the magnetization. So magnetization is vector quantity. Its SI unit is ampere per meter, because mu, that is magnetic dipole moment, is SI unit is ampere meter square upon meter cube, that is ampere per meter. So SI vector or magnetization is ampere per meter, or we can say it's a ampere meter inverse. So it's a magnetization. Again, we see the term, that is magnetic field strength. It is denoted by H, capital H. So capital H arrow, because it's a vector quantity again, the direction of magnetic field strength is the same as that of the magnetic flux or magnetic flux density, that is magnetic induction. Means direction of magnetic induction is the same as that of the H, that is magnetic field strength. So what is magnetic field strength? Consider there is one current loop, circular current carrying conductor, or a number of turns of the current carrying coil. Then N be the number of turns, I be the current flowing through the coil, and capital L is the length of magnetic flux or length of magnetic path. Then magnetic field strength H is nothing but it is a magnetomotive force. What is magnetomotive force? Magnetomotive force is nothing but it is a N into I. I is the current, N is the number of turns, upon capital L. Suppose capital L is the path length. So H arrow is equals to Ni upon L. Again, there is one relation. We know that B arrow is equals to mu into H. What is mu? Mu is nothing but it is a permeability of the material. So B arrow is equals to mu into H. So H arrow is equals to B arrow by mu. Mu is the magnetic permeability of the material here. So H arrow is equals to B arrow by H also. Again, the SI unit of magnetic field strength is ampere per meter. Its a unit is the same as that of magnetization vector. So it is a magnetic field strength. It is denoted by H arrow. Again, we see about one quantity, that is magnetic susceptibility. Magnetic susceptibility is nothing but It is the ratio of magnetization per unit magnetic field strength. Means magnetic susceptibility is denoted by chi. Means chi is equals to m arrow by h arrow. M by h. Magnetic susceptibility is the ratio of m arrow, that is magnetization, by h arrow, that is magnetic field strength. Magnetic susceptibility is denoted by chi. It's a Greek letter chi, and chi is equals to m arrow by h arrow. Magnetic susceptibility is unitless and dimensionless quantity because it's a ratio of same quantities. So it's a magnetic susceptibility. For diamagnetic substance, magnetic susceptibility is negative and small. For paramagnetic substance, magnetic susceptibility is positive and small. And but for ferromagnetic material, magnetic susceptibility is positive and it's a slightly large. So it's about magnetic susceptibility. Again, it's a unitless and dimensionless quantity. The types of magnetic materials, magnetic substances. There are three types of magnetic substances: diamagnetic substances, paramagnetic substances, and ferromagnetic substances. We know that the magnetic moment of the magnetic material or material is nothing but it is the vector sum of spin magnetic moment and orbital magnetic moment. That is mu arrow is equals to mr arrow plus ms arrow. If this vector sum of the material is a zero, then it is called a diamagnetic material. If this vector sum is a non-zero but small, then it is called a paramagnetic material. And if this vector sum is a non-zero and large, it is called a ferromagnetic material. So what is about the diamagnetic material? So diamagnetic materials are the materials basically in which in the atom of the diamagnetic material, it is found that there are even number of electrons. There are completely filled electron shell. So the total magnetic moment is zero, and this magnetic material is also known as a non-magnetic material because there is no magnetic moment. But it is found that when these types of magnetic material are placed in the influence of external magnetic field, then extra current or small extra current is induced in it, and according to Lenz's law, this current induced is opposes the external magnetic field. So magnetic susceptibility is negative and small in case of diamagnetic material. So this type of magnetic material is called as a diamagnetic material, which is weakly magnetized in opposite direction to the external magnetic field is called as diamagnetic substances. So diamagnetic substances are those substances which are weakly repelled by the magnetic field is called as diamagnetic substances. Diamagnetic substances, when placed in the influence of external magnetic field, then it get magnetized in opposite direction to the applied magnetic field. Magnetic susceptibility for the diamagnetic material is negative and small. This material is called as diamagnetic material. Examples of diamagnetic material is Au, Cu, Hg. That is the gold, copper, and mercury are the examples of the diamagnetic material. This is about the paramagnetic material. Paramagnetic material are the materials which are weakly attracted by the magnetic field. Total magnetic moment, that is mu, again we know that it's a vector sum of spin magnetic moment and orbital magnetic moment. This total magnetic moment is non-zero in case of paramagnetic material. It is found that in case of paramagnetic material, there are odd atomic numbers or number of electrons are odd. So there is a small magnetic moment and it is non-zero and small. So this is a paramagnetic material. So the paramagnetic material, when placed in an external magnetic field, in the influence of external magnetic field, then paramagnetic material get magnetized, and it is magnetized in the direction of applied magnetic field. So this material is called as paramagnetic material. That's why the paramagnetic material are weakly attracted by the magnetic field. when a paramagnetic material is placed in a magnetic field, then it get magnetized in the direction of applied magnetic field. So magnetic susceptibility for paramagnetic substance is positive and small. That is a paramagnetic material which are weakly attracted by the magnetic field. Examples of paramagnetic material are aluminium, chromium and platinum. That is a paramagnetic. Now what is about the ferromagnetic materials? Ferromagnetic materials are those which are strongly attracted by the magnetic field. In case of ferromagnetic material, mu, that is a vector sum of spin magnetic moment and orbital magnetic moment, that is total magnetic moment. Total magnetic moment is non-zero and large. So the magnetic susceptibility is positive and large in case of ferromagnetic material. When ferromagnetic material placed in external magnetic field, then it is strongly magnetized in the direction of applied magnetic field. It is called as ferromagnetic material. Ferromagnetic materials are Fe, CO and Ni. That is iron, cobalt and nickel. These are the examples of ferromagnetic substances. What is about the domain theory of ferromagnetism? We know that ferromagnetic material consists of a small regions. These small regions are called as domains. We see here why the domains are formed or how the domains are formed. Domains are nothing but it is a group of atoms. The group of those atoms which magnetic moment are in the same direction. These atoms are attracted to each other due to the strong magnetic moment, and these atoms are collected together in a small region, and these small region are called as domains. Here we see about the domain structure of the ferromagnetic material. In that we see here there are some arrows. These arrows are nothing but it is the axis of domains. Here size of domain indicate the number of atoms in that domain, and arrow, that is the axis of domain, indicate the direction of magnetic moment of all the atoms in that domain. So these are the domains, and this is domain structure of the ferromagnetic material. Domains are formed due to the atomic interactions. Domain is large, then it consists of large number of atoms. Linear size of domain is 10 raised to power minus 5 millimeter, and domain consists of a number of atoms, that is number of atoms from 10 raised to power 14 to 10 raised to power 18 atoms. So this is about the domain structure. Now we see the temperature dependence of the magnetic susceptibility. On the basis of temperature dependence, we know that magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substance is inversely proportional to temperature. So chi, magnetic susceptibility for paramagnetic substance, is inversely proportional to temperature. So it is one law, that is a Curie law. So chi is equal to Cb by T. C is a Curie constant, B is external magnetic field, and T is absolute temperature. Absolute temperature means temperature on the Kelvin scale, that is a capital T. So chi, magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substance, is inversely proportional to absolute temperature, means when temperature increases, magnetic susceptibility, that is magnetic moment, decreases. Means when temperature increases, magnetic susceptibility decreases. This is Curie law for paramagnetic material. For diamagnetic material, its magnetic susceptibility is temperature independent. Means there is no role of temperature, or there is no effect of temperature on the magnetic susceptibility of diamagnetic material. Now we see about the ferromagnetic material. There is one law, it is also known as Curie-Weiss law for ferromagnetism. So magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic substance is equals to Cb by T minus T0 or T minus Tc. Tc is the critical temperature, or we can say it's a Curie temperature also. So magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic substance is again inversely proportional to T minus Tc, that is the T minus difference between the temperature and Curie temperature. So Curie temperature is nothing but it is a temperature at which the domain structure is completely destroyed. So we see about the Curie temperature. We know that magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic material is inversely proportional to T minus Tc. Tc is the Curie temperature. As we increase the temperature of ferromagnetic material, then its magnetic susceptibility decreases. Its magnetic susceptibility decreases means its magnetic moment decreases, means ferromagnetic material loses magnetism by heating it. Means if we increase the temperature, magnetic susceptibility decreases. Magnetic moment is also decreases. As we increase the temperature, then magnetic moment decreases and domains start destroying. At a certain temperature, domain structure is completely collapse, and that temperature is called as critical temperature, or we can say it's a Curie temperature. Curie temperature is different for different materials. Curie temperature is 360 degrees Celsius for nickel. Curie temperature is 770 degrees Celsius for iron, and it is 1100 degrees Celsius for cobalt. So Curie temperature is different for different material. Curie temperature is that temperature at which the domain structure is completely collapsed. So above Curie temperature, ferromagnetic substance behaves as a paramagnetic substance. When it is heated above the Curie temperature, then ferromagnetic substance behaves as a